Hi there. This is going to be a quick demonstration on how to how to connect the throttle and the features of the carburetor on the HuaSheng 49cc 4-stroke. And I'll just quickly go through this. Turn the engine so you can see it a little better. Okay, so I'm just going to turn the throttle or the choke over to one side so it's easier to see what I'm doing. This is the throttle cable for the carburetor. This bracket here with the adjustable threads on here is for the throttle cable. Throttle cable passes through this, and it's adjustable, so you can adjust your carburetor length or throttle cable length. And then just move that over to the side here on the top. You can see that there's a slot and the throttle cable fits through the slot, and then the little tab on the end fits into a holder and it basically locks into place. You can get it wrong. If it's turned 180, it'll slip in, but it will not lock, and you can tell because the little tab will be sticking out. So just turn it 180 and in it goes, and it locks into place. I'll just do a little demonstration with the throttle here if I can get my fingers on it properly here. Okay, so there you can see the throttle moving the way it's supposed to. Alright, we'll just take that out of the way. Okay, and choke demonstration. When the choke is to the transmission side, pointing to the transmission side, the choke is off. When it's to the pull cord side of the engine, the choke is on. Okay, and switch to the side here and explain a little bit about the fittings on the side of the carburetor. This particular one right here is an overflow drain hose. If the carburetor gets overfilled with fuel, it will drain out this hole. Like if you tip the bike over it, and the fuel starts to flow out, it'll flow out of this. The one that's lower next to the fuel bowl, closer to the fuel bowl, is the fuel inlet. That's where when you purchase this kit, for whatever reason, the fuel line isn't provided. So you'll have to purchase fuel line, and the fuel line goes from your fuel tank to a inline fuel filter, of which you need to purchase for this engine kit. If you don't, you'll discover you're going to run into lots of troubles down the road. And then it connects to here. Okay, and then we'll just turn this around here, and I'll show you a couple of more things about the carburetor. Just adjusting my position here. Okay, and this hose is another drain hose, but this is the float bowl drain for the carburetor, and what I'm pointing to right here is you can put a flat-headed screwdriver in here and open this about a turn and a half, and as long as you have your fuel turned off, it will drain the carburetor for extended storage, and then that way you won't have any problems with your fuel turning to varnish. This little piece right here that I'm pointing to right now is the air mixture screw for your rich and lean mixture for the carburetor. And then lastly, I'll just do a quick demonstration on how to remove the air filter. And there's two tabs that you can push, one on either side, one there and one here. And then it just rocks back and then becomes open, and then there's foam inside. This should have a protective, or should have an oil coating for air foam filters. There's the two bolts that hold. Yes, you did it. Oh, good girl. I'll be right there. There's two bolts right here that hold the whole carburetor in place. And lastly, there's a little inlet, and you can't really see it, and it's going to be difficult for you to see, period. Right here, there is a crankcase vent tube, and it goes from the crankcase to the air filter box, and it lets any blow-by from the rings into the air box, and then it gets reburned by the carburetor. Okay, so that is the demonstration for the HuaSheng 49cc. I hope this helps some people. I know it will help Corwin. Okay, and that's it. Thanks for watching.